With us now is Zach. And Zach Schur, wow, a huge entire team of 20 under signature properties. We're going to be talking to him about how to market your home. Welcome. How are you?
I'm doing well. How about yourself?
Good. So good for you. You've sold, what was it, over 200 homes this year?
Yes. This past year, we sold over 200 houses.
My goodness. Yep. I have a question. Did you, were you the listing agent and the selling and the buying agent on any of the homes?
Yes.
Like, could you imagine, like, somebody rotate it, right? Did you do that?
Yeah. Okay. There were certainly times where we not only listed the home, but we also brought the buyer as well. Absolutely.
Okay. And did any of your homeowners move from like one address into someone else's house?
Which, you know, it's a really funny story. Not this past year, but okay. Previously had literally a rotation of a seller
right.
buying and a buyer selling at the same time. And they both purchased each other's houses.
I love that. You never think about that, but yeah, somebody might want to downsize and somebody might want to upsize. And it was time for them to just swap houses.
Literally exactly what happened. And it's such a rare thing. That's the only time in my career I've ever had that happen, but it was pretty cool.
And it worked out.
Yeah, it did.
Oh, that's so lovely. And then they probably call one another and be like, oh yeah, where's that light switch?
All the time. Yep.
Too fun. So what made you decide to get into real estate?
You know, for me, it was actually kind of on a whim, you know, okay. So originally my thought for, you know, my background prior to getting into real estate was marketing and advertising, and I was also teaching. So I was a full-time professor. So one summer I had off, I decided, hey, you know what, I'll get my real estate license. I was planning on flipping a few houses, wanted to represent myself. And then it just kind of took on a life of its own. Within my first 6 months, I realized that this was my passion and my career, and it kind of just brought everything together, you know, that I did. And then the following year, you know, I slowly kind of went away from all of my other endeavors and just focused on real estate.
And having that teaching background, I think it's important when you're leading a team.
So you
have 20 different people. It's almost like you still have a classroom in a way.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Very, very much so. It's always, and it's a learning experience for me as well. And what I had always found that as I was teaching, I was also learning from my students. So it's the same thing with a team. We all have different backgrounds. We all have different strengths and weaknesses. So we feed off of each other. So I'm able to kind of project what I do and the way that I do things, but I also learn from my team members things that they do really well. And we kind of had that nice synergy together. And that's what I think really truly makes us as successful as we are.
What challenges are homeowners facing right now when they're trying to list their properties that we could help them with? Let's give them a couple of tips.
Sure. So right now, the market is obviously pretty strong. You know, over the last couple of years, you really haven't had to do much to sell your house. But to maximize the potential for your sale, you have to do a few things.
Okay.
You know, you have to, first of all, you have to really put your best foot forward. And part of that is marketing and advertising your house, not just by, you know, putting it up online, putting a sign out in front and hoping it sells. One thing and a big strength of our team, and obviously from my background from marketing and advertising, we truly know how to do that. So social media is obviously huge right now, you know, no matter what industry you're in, but that's been a driving force for us to be able to bring more buyers to our sellers' homes. So something that I could absolutely recommend to them would be hiring someone like myself, you know, hiring a real estate professional to help you sell your house.
And to bring the personality of the home forward.
Absolutely.
Anybody can look at a floor plan and be like, all right, well, this is the square footage of the room.
Yep.
But if you walk through that threshold and you can see that personality
sure.
shine forth, then you can visualize yourself as a buyer in that house.
Absolutely.
And people need to realize that. So maybe you have a whole wall of all your grandchildren, you know, and that you love,
yep.
you know, but this might be a good time to maybe just take them down
sure.
and put the pictures in a book.
Absolutely.
Or like wrap them up and put them in your new home. But any type of over-personalization is something that they might want to take
We talk about depersonalizing the home, decluttering, trying to make it feel as open and as, you know, so that the new buyer can kind of visualize themselves there.
Yeah, where are my shoes going to go?
Right, exactly. It doesn't have to be a museum. You know, people realize that you're still living there, so you don't have to put everything away, but you want to make it so that it feels like it can be their home as well.
Clean bathrooms,
yep.
so important.
Yep.
Cabinet doors that, you know, open and close, like mm-hmm. the knobs not like falling off in somebody's hand.
Yeah.
These are like some simple things that a homeowner, because, oh, well, that's the way the drawer has always closed. Don't cut it when you're trying to list your house.
Right. You know, you really, like, again, put your best foot forward. If you can see something that's not perfect, you know, you try to make it as best as you can. Absolutely.
What's one of the craziest things that you've ever seen in a home that you had to try to list?
Oh,
because everybody's got a story, and I love the stories.
There's been so many different things. You know, it's what's honestly what's the strangest thing is when you know, you go into a home, you see it one way, and everybody sees the pictures and everything like that, you know, what comes up about the house, but it's when you first walk in. So from the perspective of working with buyers, it's going into a house, walking in with them, and totally seeing the complete opposite of what we saw in the photos previously.
Oh,
so you
okay.
walk in and, you know, all the rooms always look huge online, and then they're so much smaller, you know, and then when you go into the different, you know, so it's about, you know, kind of looking at the house from a different perspective sometimes.
Realistic.
Yeah,
realistic standpoint.
Absolutely. Yes.
And your house should smell good. Remember, yes, always, like you should either have like cinnamon boiling on the stove or something.
Yep,
it should
yep.
smell fresh.
It should. Absolutely. They, you know, they used to say like have, you know, cookies baking in the oven, you know, but it's just, you want to, you know, all of our senses factor in when we're looking for a home because it's an emotional experience.
Yes.
So everything ties together. So absolutely. If the house smells at least just fresh, clean, it makes a big difference. And have it be bright too. You know, have the windows, you know, the curtains raised, you know,
yes.
just bringing in that natural light. It'll just make the experience for the buyer feel so much better.
Another thing that I think people don't notice is on your closet doors, sometimes you have fingerprints on your handles and stuff like
sure.
that.
Yeah.
Little things that you just don't see on an, but like going through the details, I think can also make your house just look fresh and bright. Just take
absolutely.
A little like Windex and wash those fingerprints off.
Yeah, yeah. Anything that you can do. And those are the type of things that don't cost you any money. And there are a lot of those types of things that homeowners can do to really help sell their house. You know, it doesn't have to cost thousands of dollars. You don't have to go through crazy renovations. Right now, there's a buyer for every type of house. It doesn't have to be picture perfect. But the best, you know, the best way you can present your house is where you want to be.
And so that's what you do. You bring somebody in, you'll educate them, you'll walk them through, you'll market their house in a fun and exciting way.
Yep.
And then that will hopefully shorten the days on the market.
Absolutely. Each house is totally different, right? So the way that we market and advertise each house is different. So for certain houses, it's better to do a full video for it where we narrate the house, where we talk about the different fun, great features. Other ones, maybe it's better to not. You know, we have to look at each house differently. And that's why, you know, again, we want to focus on the features that really are going to help sell each house. So everyone's different.
And also, not to overprice your home. See, just because the guy next door got an extra $150,000 and then all of a sudden you market your house and you're going to ask for that same price,
mm-hmm.
right? It's got to still be competitive at some point.
Absolutely.
Because people they're going to want to get a good value, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to be like, oh yeah, I'll just spend whatever it was. When the flight from the city was happening and the houses were going for that much more money,
yep.
I think it's kind of like backed off a little bit.
We've been noticing a little bit, not so much of a slowdown necessarily, because
okay.
even this past weekend, we had open houses with over 50 families.
Wow.
Lines out the door still. We're still seeing it, but I think prices have begun to kind of calm down a little bit.
Be a little more reasonable.
It's shifting a little bit more, not to a buyer's market, but to a more normalized market, where buyers have an opportunity to actually somewhat negotiate or ask for certain things. Where in the past it was, what do I have to
take
do to get this house?
It.
I'll give you $50,000 over, I'll waive my inspection, appraisal, let me just give me the house, you
right.
know?
I don't care that there's crumbs
on
the roof.
No,
right? I don't need a new roof, right?
Don't need anything, just let me buy it. And it's like, but you see a lot of those people that bought houses a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, are starting to list their house
okay.
because they weren't necessarily happy with what they got.
Got it,
you know,
and now they've got some more choice.
They have more choice. They've, even from a year and a half ago, we've had appreciation in the market. We have a good amount. So they have equity that they've already built in.
Lovely.
So we've, you know, the ability for those sellers to be able to now buy again, you know, is here.
That's important too, because it used to be a rule of thumb. You have to hold it for 10 years.
Right.
Right. Good for you.
Yeah,
this is great, Zach. I cannot thank you enough for stopping by today.
I appreciate you having me.
Yeah. So it's your team.
Yep.
And you're through Signature Properties, and
yep.
they could reach out to you and you'll be willing to onboard them.
Absolutely.
Thank you. There you go. So whether you're in a house, you want a house, you had a house, now you want a different house, it's all there. It's all good for you. Stay tuned for more. We've been living it up right here.